Welcome to my outside voice. Good to talk to you all. We're gathered here in the Joint Institute for Advanced Materials building, JIAM for short. As you already heard, it's about 142,000 gross square feet. It's actually got about 91,000 of net assignable square feet in it. This building represents a fundamental change for the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. If you think about universities, a lot of them have a tradition of drawing out of the monastic background. And the thing about monks is they tend to stay away from each other, okay? And that you tend to have silos. And universities are very good at being organized on a disciplinary basis. But this building is the first intentional building that is deliberately designed to break down disciplinary boundaries across a research theme. And the research theme is advanced materials. But the idea is to get all these folks in one place and get them collaborating. So when I say all these folks, whom I'm talking about? About 40 faculty members distributed over about 7 departments, 3 colleges, and actually more than one campus here in Knoxville. There'll be 150 graduate students. There'll be 45 research faculty and postdocs. These are all PhD varying folks. Those are the folks associated with the institutions and the colleges.
You're in an electron microscopy suite. Now, number one, if you notice in here, the way the sound is, it's different. And sound is your enemy because it creates vibration with an electron microscope. And the other thing is the concrete, the amount of concrete, the kind of floor, the kind of stability you need so you don't have vibration is also key. So you're in a vault, and it's sound defined as well as structurally defined from the standpoint of vibration and movement. The kinds of scopes we'll have in here, there'll be 3 scopes. One of them is on loan from Oak Ridge National Lab, and it's a standard electron microscope like I worked on, although it doesn't do biological materials, but it can do a lot of standard things. And then there are 2 new scopes that Knoxville, the University of Tennessee Knoxville, has purchased for $3.6 million. They're made by a manufacturer called Zeiss. They're world renowned around microscopes. Now, one of them will be a tunneling electron microscope, and it'll be able to get you down to particle sizes of an atom. And actually, one of the things that might be an example of the kinds of things you can do with that kind of detail is the ability to identify optically reactive particles that help you in detecting things like the agent mustard gas at really nano levels. And then there'll be a scanning electron microscope that has an ion beam in it that will allow you to, in a material science building like this, you want to reshape nanoparticles. It allows you to not only visualize them, but reshape them. So this is a good example of a facility that will put us at the cutting edge from the standpoint of the technology that's needed to be on the edge of the best research, but also get the best faculty, governor's chairs, and more importantly, students here. And from the standpoint of this innovation campus, businesses are going to be attracted to this kind of capability.
Some of the research we're doing is to look at sort of superstructure materials, something that you can extend a long way, a polymer, which is a long chain molecule, you can extend it a long way and it won't break. That can be used on tennis shoes, okay? It can also be used on coatings of surfaces for objects that are going to be under stress, undergoing shape changes, and you want to have that flexibility. These offices take 1, 2, 3 people. They're intended to be flexible. The director for the Joint Institute, George Farr, he's not going to be into people who have turf. If we need to reassign people so we can have a new collaborative team, we'll be doing that. All right. But another thing about this is this speaks to the design of the building. This building is working to become a LEED Gold certified building. So one of the things that you see here is daylight entering into the building. In an old building, you just have solid walls there and the daylight would cut off at the offices and you'd be in the tunnel. And if you're lucky, there's a window at the end, but maybe not. They block that off so you could really get that whole tunnel experience. But also things like this sheetrock right here, it's got recycled materials in it, okay? So that's another green aspect associated with the building. We're working always on collaboration. This is a shared research space around a research theme. And we really want this to succeed because we need to do more like this in building research as we go forward on the campus and in the university. So thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
I hope it was useful. And have fun at the MDF. It's a cool facility.